Later, he said that he had not read it yet. I may be in for a big surprise, folks. Trump said he hoped the meeting would be ultimately successful, but said he did not expect concrete results, like North Korea's denuclearization, stressing that the meeting is the start of a process. Remember what I say, we will see what we will see, he said. Kim Jong-kol arrived in New York on Wednesday for talks with Secretary of State Mike Pompeo. The diplomat is the highest-ranking North Korean official to visit the U.S. since 2000, when Cho Myung-rok, the late vice marshal, met with then-President Bill Clinton in Washington. On Sunday, officials from North Korea and the U.S. met for talks at the Truce Village in the demilitarized zone that separates the Korean Peninsula. President Trump said in a tweet that officials were there to make arrangements for the summit. One day prior, South Korean President Moon Jae-in, who was reportedly blindsided by Trump's decision to pull out of the summit, traveled to the DMZ for an impromptu meeting with Kim Jong-un. Moon later told reporters that the two leaders agreed the summit must be successfully held. With the summit now back on the table, attention will likely shift to the substance of the meeting and whether Trump and Kim will be able to get on the same page about how to best denuclearize the Korean Peninsula. Cho Myung-jun, the South Korean unification minister, warned this week that significant differences remain between the U.S. and North Korea on how to achieve denuclearization. Now that the leaders of the two countries are engaging in talks in a top-down manner, I think the chances are high that common ground can be found, Cho said. Marina Fang contributed reporting. Video: How likely is a successful summit? Watch News TV and more on News Pulse View.